I appreciate your compliance, and welcome to our performance of Annie.
Thank you. It's all right. I'll get it all.
Aha! Come here! I hear you. I always hear you. Get up, kid! Up! Turn around! I said turn around! There! Now what you say? What do you say?
I love you,
Jerry. Rotten orphan.
I am not an orphan! My mother found out the note saying they love you and coming back to me.
That was 1922. 1933. You in here, get up! Get up! Put them things away. For this one, shenanigans, go scrub the floors and strip the beds for the laundryman.
But it's 4 o'clock in the morning.
I know. And you'll get down on your knobby little knees and clean this dump until it shines like the top of the Chrysler Building. Get to work!
Yes, Miss Shenanigans.
Now! Why any kid would want to be an orphan, I'll never know.
Because I'm saving it for my wedding. call this clean, Annie? This place looks like a pigsty.
Annie?
Annie, where is that Annie?
Annie ain't here!
What do you mean? Annie ain't here.
She just went with the bundle in the laundry basket.
Bundle? The laundry basket? Leave! I can live like that!
No more hard time for Annie!
Yeah!
Tomorrow, I love you. Tomorrow, you're always a
you gotta be optimistic about? Look at us. Life's a nightmare.
Well, you gotta have a dream.
Traffic girls are hurt all night.
What gave you a nightmare?
Empty pockets.
At least you got a pocket.
Freezing fingers.
She got the empty pocket.
Newspapers for blankets.
You can read in bed.
You gotta love her, kid.
All right, move on, all you punks out of here.
You're not punks.
Tear the other junk pile now.
Come on. Come on, Sandy, run.
Leave me alone. I live here.
Thank you.
Hold it. Look, I get it.
If it's beauty products you're peddling, well,
I'm sure you can see that I don't need them. So,
Miss Hampton, I'm sorry, but I'm not peddling anything. I'm private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
Oliver Warbucks? The Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks.
Oh, I read a Winchell call that Oliver Warbucks has more dough than me than Rockefeller.
I will know. I will read, Mr. Winchell. Miss Hannigan, Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite orphans for the Christmas holidays at home, and I'm here to select them for him.
Well, you're sure he wouldn't rather have a lady? I got 2 weeks coming. What sort of orphan did you have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly and intelligent.
Mississippi. It was a society to keep you out of Mississippi.
And cheerful.
And how old?
Oh, well, age doesn't really matter. Say 8 or 9? 10. 11? Yes, 11 would be just perfect. And Mr. Warbucks prefers redheaded children.
Nope. Ain't got any of those around here.
Well, what about this child?
Annie? No. You don't know Annie. She's a drunk and a liar, Mr. Fred. A drunk and a liar.
Yes, I'm sure she's a drunk and a liar. Annie, come here. Annie, how would you like to spend the next 2 weeks with Mr. Warbucks at his house?
Oh, boy, I'd love to. I'd really love to.
No. You can have any orphan you want, but not Annie.
Why?
I just told you she's...
Miss Hannigan.
She's entirely too cheeky.
I assume this has something to do with all that business about the laundry bag and the police. Perhaps I should call Mr. Donatelli. Sign it.
I'm an easy gal to go along with. If it's any you want, if any you give it.
It's any I want. So if you give her coat, I'll take her along.
Coat? Annie ain't got no coat.
All right. Then we'll buy her one.
Oh, boy!
We'll go to Saks and get you a warm winter coat. Come along, Annie. Mr. Warbucks' limousine's waiting outside.
Oh, boy! I can hardly believe it.
She can hardly believe it.
Good day, Miss Hannigan. And be free.
Thank you.
later. Anyone else?
J.D. Rockefeller, Mahatma Gandhi, and Harpo Marx, sir.
By the way, what Harpo want?
He didn't say. Mr. Warbucks, I'd like you to meet.
Great, I'll be my sworn genuine. And if you, I won't be having dinner tonight, and I have tons of work to do.
Yes, sir.
And Grace, I'll leave you for dictation.
Yes, sir.
Alright. Good to see you all again.
Welcome home, Mr. Warbucks.
What is this? Grace, if you'll leave your notebook, we can. And who is this?
This is Annie, Mr. Warbucks. The orphan staying with us for Christmas?
Orphans? Orphans are boys. That's not a boy.
I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphan, so I chose a girl.
Well, I guess you'll have to do. Annie, huh? Annie what?
Sir?
Your last name, child.
I don't have any last name that I know of.
So you're just Annie?
Yep, just Annie. Sorry, my boy.
I don't suppose you would like to meet Lou Gehrig.
Oh boy, sure. Who's Lou Gehrig?
I couldn't be happier that you'd be spending Christmas Eve with us, Annie. Anyway, Chris is over here to come to the high ore shipments from Toledo. What are we supposed to be doing with this child?
So it's her first time here.
It is? Oh. Well, I guess we should do something special for her then. Hey, come sit down over here. How would you like to go to the
movies? Oh, boy, sure. I heard about a Belgium, but I've never been to one.
Never?
Okay.
Well, we must change that right away. Nothing but the best for you, Eddie. Let's see, you'll go to the Roxy. Then you'll have an ice cream soda at Rumpelmeyer's. And then a handsome cab ride through Central Park.
Golly.
Grace, forget about the vacation. Instead, we'll be taking Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir. Gosh.
Something wrong, Annie?
No,
no, no, you can tell me. You don't want to go to the rock.
No, I do, sir. I just thought you were going to take me.
No, Annie, I'm far too busy to do that sort of thing.
Well, that's okay, sir.
You see, Annie, when a man runs a multi-billion dollar corporation, he can't just be...
That's okay, sir.
I'm kidding. Excuse me, sir? Telephone call?
Hello, Barney? Barney. No, just got in this morning. No, Detroit and Chicago. Barney, I didn't like what I saw up there. Factory shut down. My factory shut down. Damn it, Barney, you gotta get your friend Roosevelt to fix this thing. He has to come up with something. A new plan, a new assessment, a new something. Yes, I know he's a Democrat, but he's a human being, too. We can discuss it later, Barney. Why don't you come over tonight? We can have lunch, at... You know what, Barney? Let's make that tomorrow. Okay? Tonight I have a date with a 10-year-old girl.
11!
Oh, my mistake. She's 11. Good night, buddy. Great!
Yes, sir?
Close.
Of course.
You coming along too, of course?
Of course, sir.
Why see I
without you. But I can't get enough. He's a cab driver in Lakewood.
But I can't get Yesterday.
The Waldorf?
Oh no, I believe it's the Autobot? And she just loves spring coat. She never takes it off.
Never?
Never. Miss Hannigan, I know that you're a very busy woman, but this needs to be signed and sent back to Mr. Donatelli by no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
What for?
Because Mr. Warbucks is so taken with Annie that, guess what?
What?
He wants to adopt her.
But,
and Mr. Warbucks asked the job by in person to tell you that Annie won't be coming back here. Ever.
Ever? Will you excuse me for just a moment?
Of course.
How can you manage to get that bench up like this, huh? I'm the skids.